Hello, this is Heber Barbero with video number 4 of the series Introduction to KDEC-Online.com. In this video, we're going to talk about laminate stiffness. In previous videos, we have looked at how to register for an account and then how to log in into the account. I am already logged in into the account that we created in video number 2. And then in video number 3, we look at how to enter fibers and matrices and create laminas. Here is Kevlar 149 that we enter in video number 3. We enter these properties. And for matrix, we will use epoxy as we've done in video number 3. And in video number 3, we created this lamina that is the Kevlar epoxy lamina that we're going to use today. So once we have laminas, we can make laminates. Just like we do in reality, we can do here on the computer. To make laminates, now it's kind of obvious what we had to do. We had to go click here on laminates to see what laminates we have and to add another. Now the system put these laminates for you in your section of the database. You can delete them, and you're not deleting the examples on my account. But if you delete them, then you don't have examples, so I don't recommend you do that. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna add another laminate, and for that we go to the plus sign. Yes, we go here, we click, and we have a new laminate. So new laminate that we're going to do is a very simple laminate, and I'm going to call it, you can call it whatever you want, but I'm going to call it 090 symmetric. All right, so that's the name I like. Now there is some more stuff here like load factor, resistance factor, damage factor that I'm not going to explain today. You can learn about it. Everything is explained in this book, of course. Or maybe in the future we make another video, but for today we're just going to leave the default. And then we're going to make a symmetric laminate because the interpretation of the result is easier with symmetric laminate, but you don't have to. So today, to make a symmetric laminate, we're going to click here where it says symmetric layers. So you can see that the system immediately puts one lamina here, but it puts E-glass epoxy. I don't want E-glass epoxy, I want Kevlar epoxy. So what I have to do, I open up and I see what do I have. What are these? These are laminas, yes? All right? And where is my Kevlar epoxy? Right there. So when I put this, it replicates the Kevlar epoxy there as a second lamina. The laminas are numbered from the bottom because that's the way we fabricate composite. We put one lamina on the mold, then we put lamina 2 on top. But I really need a 090 symmetric. It's a four lamina laminate. So I need more laminas. So what I have to do is I gotta go here and click in the plus, and it will open up space. Lamina 2 replicated into 3 and to 4. But E-glass epoxy, I don't want. You can use different material for different laminas, and that will be a hybrid laminate. In this way, you can make, for example, a sandwich shell with a Kevlar epoxy on the outside and a foam in the middle. All you have to do is define foam as a lamina, and then you're selected here. But today, we're going to do a traditional laminate where everything is the same material. So Kevlar epoxy, which was defined in video number 3. And then this angle is 0 because I want to be 0. And then this is 90 because I want it to be 90. And this thickness for the 90, I want to make it thicker, like that. And you can see it replicates symmetric. If I don't want symmetric, I can uncheck here, and I got unsymmetric, and check again, and I have symmetric again, so no problem. And once I'm done with this, then I save my 090 symmetric laminate, like that, success. There, and I go to laminates, and then I find it here at the bottom, 090 symmetric laminate. So once you have laminates, then you can calculate things. And for that, we go to chapters. And you remember, if you have laminas, you can do micromechanics. Also, if you have laminas, you can do plane mechanics, but I'm not going to explain this because you can learn on your own. And it's useful to do calculations, to do homework, to do stress transformation. Sometimes you need this for analysis, for design. But then today with laminates, we open up the possibility to do macromechanics and strength. Macromechanics basically is calculation of stiffness, strains, and strength and stresses, but strength is failure. So we're going to do macromechanics. We open up and then we discover that we can work with intact material, which is the material new, no damage, and degraded material. Somehow the material was damaged and the software can handle that. So we're going to do intact. And so we open up and we say, oh, what can we do with this intact material? Well, first we can calculate the density. But since all the laminas are Kevlar epoxy, the density of the laminate is going to be the same as the lamina, so that's not very interesting. Laminate coefficient of thermal expansion we can calculate, but you recall we didn't put the right value of the coefficient of thermal expansion of the fiber because we didn't know for Kevlar. So, okay, we're going to skip that. You can learn that later. Now, if we have the thermal properties right, and we have a change of temperature or a change of moisture content, thermal stresses and thermal and moisture stresses will be generated, and forces, thermal forces and bending moments and moisture forces and moisture moments will be produced, and the software can calculate that, but it's a little bit difficult to explain, so you gotta read the book to understand this. So another thing that we can do is to calculate the Q matrices for all the laminas, which you can do with plane mechanics one lamina at a time. But here, for convenience, there is this button which I'm going to click, and it gives me the Q and Q star for each lamina. This is not a laminate, but for each lamina, but I can pick the laminate, my laminate, which is a 090 symmetric. And then it says, okay, lamina 1, which is at 0.127 millimeter, it has this Q matrix and this Q bar matrix, which are identical because the angle is zero, the orientation is zero, so the two are the same. And the Q star, you know, are here. Maybe you have to read about this. But then if I want the other lamina, okay, the two, immediately I have it here. And they're not very different because the angle is 90. So only thing that happens is that these two numbers in the diagonal swap places over here, and these two numbers swap places over there. But if the angles are complicated and you have many angles and many lamina, this is handy, okay? This is convenient. Another thing that I can, and if you want these numbers and you don't want to copy them by hand, then you could, what you can do is you can click here to Excel and it's going to dump these numbers into Excel. So we click, and here it is into Excel. Now we open with Excel, and there comes Excel. And okay, and it says, all right, this is what you're doing. And then here on top, it says lamina 1, and you have all the properties. And lamina 2, and you got all the properties, and so on. All right, so okay, we're done with that. So now, what we can do next is we can calculate the ABD matrices, which you probably know what they are. And why? Because we have to do some homework, or we gotta enter ABD matrices into some other software like Abacus. So we click here, and we got a page, and we select always our lamina. Don't forget that. And it's going to do this ABD matrices and H also. It doesn't show us the formula because there is a bunch of formulas. So and so then, okay, but what are the results? The results are not shown here in this page. They are shown here into Excel. So all these little numbers, right, 6 by 6, plus 2 by 2, all these numbers are here to Excel, and you know how to get there, and you can get those numbers directly into Excel. What the page is doing is, again, trying to be a graphic calculator. Meaning that, okay, I got this equation. What if I put numbers here and put numbers here on the right? Multiply by these numbers that the computer already knows what they are, and give me these numbers. And there we go. Here I have a strain of 20,000 microstrain and 0, 0, 0, everything else is 0, and it calculates the membrane forces and the bending moments. And the bending moments are 0 because the laminate is symmetric, so if I put an in-plane load, I only get membrane forces. You have to think about that, all right? So in the same way, this is basically the stiffness of the laminate. I could calculate the compliance of the laminate by clicking on this alpha, beta, delta. And again, I select which one, 090, all right? And of course, I need some loads, and we forgot to put loads, but don't worry about it because this is like a graphing calculator, I can change things. And so here is the compliance matrix, and any number I put here and any number I put there, I'm gonna calculate this side. And how do I do that? Well, put the numbers here. The apparently example 6.2 has an NX of 1, yes, but you can change it. You can put 1,000 and nothing happens. And you, when you move over here, it recalculates, and here you got, all right? This is the strain, and this other strain, and this is 0. And this is 10 to the minus 6, 10 to the minus 6, very 10 to the minus 15, 10 to the minus 14, very small because, again, I put only membrane forces on a symmetric laminate, so I have no curvatures, and software calculates very small curvatures. And if I really want the numbers for these values, which you may need, you just dump it to Excel, and you get them there. Okay, so once we got that, then we go to laminate moduli. Laminate moduli really, what it does, it represents the laminate as an orthotropic plate, homogeneous orthotropic plate. The laminate is not really an orthotropic plate, but it can be represented pretty close by an orthotropic equivalent orthotropic homogeneous plate. And why we want to do that? Because there are handbooks with lots of solutions for various problems, pipes with internal pressure, bending, axial load, buckling, domes, you name it. But they are all for orthotropic plates, no or shells, no for laminates. So if you can represent a laminate by an equivalent orthotropic plate or shell, then you can use all those solutions to design all kind of stuff. Now there are two types of moduli, in-plane and bending. And this depends on the stress that you anticipate the structure will have. Is it mostly in plane or is it mostly bending? And then you pick here. If it's mostly in plane, like say a tube and an under axial load, then you go here and then you pick your laminate there. And these are the equations for the E's of the laminate, all right, and G's, all right? And here it says what the LS says. Yes, we put 090 symmetric. And here it gives you EX, EY, GXY, and Poisson, and so on. And of course, you can send them to Excel. And you can use these numbers to do the design of a variety of structures, lots of problems by just looking at handbook solutions. All right? So then also you can calculate strains. Given some loads, you can calculate strains, and you can get the strains into the laminate coordinate system or into the lamina coordinate system, depending on what you need. And so if you are doing a strength calculation, you want it in this system, all right? And then the stresses also can calculate the stress in laminate coordinate system or in lamina coordinate system. And we can say click here to see what that does. First, we gotta choose our lamina, which is the 090. And shell load, we leave the example. And environment, there is a built-in no environment, mean no temperature and no moisture. And then what stress do you wanna plot? Well, sigma one, okay. Sigma one for all the laminas, all right? And so apparently, for example, 6.2, the load is NX1 Newton per millimeter, but I can change it and put 500, all right? And so, and this is all zero, right? And when I change the focus of the cursor, it will calculate, and it says, oh, okay, that's what you have. Sigma 1, which is what you ask here. Sigma 1, through the thickness, is this. So you have like a 1600 MPa stress on the zero layers. Yes, the zero layers because they are loaded. Okay, let's look at the load. So this is the in-plane and shear loads. And what we put was NX 500. So we put, we're pulling with 500, but we didn't put any bending, no transverse shear, no in-plane shear. No, the only thing we're doing is pulling with 500 here and 500 there, right? Yes. So let's see. Yes, we're pulling with 500 there. All right. And when you pull, the zero layers have to take all that load, and that's why you get this stress over here. And in lamina coordinate system, the one is perpendicular to this direction, x. So the stress on the 90 is zero. And we got total hydrothermal, which is in orange, you see zero because we didn't put temperature or moisture. And the mechanical is blue, is hiding behind the green in this case. And these values of stress, if you're not sure that this is 1600 or 1700, no problem, you dump it to Excel and you got all the numbers, all right? And then if you say you want another direction, you just pick another direction, sigma 2, software calculates, and now we got something more interesting. The stresses are smaller because these are Poisson effects, but you see a decent amount of stress, Poisson effect, develops on the 90 degree lamina, and the zero has very little, and you can think about this later. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Very quickly, we have gone through macromechanics, which is basically the stiffness calculations for the laminate. And in the next video, we're going to look at strength, all right, which is very interesting. And with that, I thank you very much.